Hi guys, Gale Banks here. A few of you have sent me a link to a video you say I've just caught to see. So I think it's time for another fact check. Oh.
What? Whoa, what are you talking about?
That's not true!
Try again!
So get your facts straight.
Oh my God, it's Barry at S&B. This is gonna be interesting.
Hi, this is Barry from S&B, and today I'm here to talk to you about our new intake, new open style intake kit. And I know you're probably saying, hey, what is S&B doing an S&B, you know,
wow, this is interesting.
Intake? For years, all we've done is preach how a closed intake system is better.
Wait a minute.
Don't get me wrong. It comes down to restrictions.
So you're going to do an open style, but you believe that closed is better.
The density of the air, which
why
is
are you doing this?
Better performance and makes your truck perform better. However,
this is double talk already in
a closed style intake, and that is, if you ask me what the best intake kit is for your vehicle, I'm going to say it's a closed style intake with our sealed box, whether it's a dry filter or cleanable filter. However, there are customers out there that want an open style intake. For whatever reason, that's the intake they want, and who am I to tell them that they can't have that? And
so you should be the authority. That's
an open style
who
intake
you should be.
Done the S&B way.
My God.
So that it is
he's going to sell something he doesn't believe in for the money. I can't believe it. You're going to sell something. Has this guy got no scruples? I can't wait to see how he justifies doing this. Let's go for some more here.
Install is super clean, no check engine lights, carb exempt. All the key ingredients to making a great intake so that it's good for the consumer, and just it really comes down to a super clean install as well. So let me talk
super clean open element.
We designed this intake.
I wonder how much he's going to sell it for.
The good parts of this kit don't stop there. We've got an enormous tube. The opening of this tube is 5.5 by 6, I believe. And it gives you over 350 inches of airspace. We use a special insert so that we can still get a huge tube and make it so that you don't get check engine lights just
Where does this tube go?
You do not need a tune to run this intake. Huge tube, rotor molded.
Yep, perfect. Pull it apart, and I want you to look inside and see what they've done. I need a
look inside where?
I want you to peel it in half. The clamp is loose. I don't want to say more.
All right.
Just please, yeah.
I got to see this for real. And I've got one. Right here. We'll pull a tube out of the filter. What the hell is this? You've got a big tube. Yeah, I give you that, Barry, but oh. What a jackass. What the hell is this? You've got a big tube. You restrict it down to that. Oh my God. Oh my God. And you're doing a lot of work to the air. You're changing the form factor from round to rectangular. Oh my God. So what do you put on the flow bench, Barry? This or this or these together? Oh my God. Oh, I got it. This is necessary because he did a big tube. His MAF sensor goes right there. To get the velocity correct, you have to bring the cross-sectional area down to what it would have been if the tube size were OEM. The thing that really prevents you running a big tube without some gimmick like this is the MAF sensor won't read correctly. This is like some guy who puts a sock in his shorts. So he can sport his manhood, and it's totally fake. Oh my God. Oh, I'm not, this is comedy. But the other part of the comedy is this is no better flowing in reality than this stock cross-section would be at the MAF sensor. Yeah, we got a big air filter here. There's no two ways about it. Everything being big is moot. It doesn't matter. On our Duramax 20 and up ram air system, I've got a big tube, and it really works. And there's no restrictor inside. True, a big tube flows better, no question. And the way I solve this dilemma of incorrect MAF sensor reading is I designed and patented an air mass control module. And it adjusts the signal from the MAF sensor so that it is correct. Now I've got a design latitude on all this intake stuff that no one else can do for 20 years. So we now have the freedom to design the tubes any way we want in any car or truck. I don't know if I can stomach any more of this video, but.
And so forth. We
glutton for punishment.
Open style intake. We relocate the battery, so we get
hot
the
awesome
battery tray, just like we do with our
under the
intake.
Hood.
And you're able to relocate the battery to the rear, allowing to have a shorter tube, so you're not you eliminate all that restriction that you get.
From an the awesome
stock
battery
system.
Tray.
The stock system on the 17 to 19 power stroke is just
okay with our restrictive. In fact, with our Ford product, we do not
improve the airflow.
Relocate the battery, and we move more mass flow, not CFM. Remember the MAF sensor? It's sensing the mass flow, not the CFM. That's what the engine management cares about. Pounds of air, not cubic feet of air. You mix pounds of air with pounds of fuel in the correct air-fuel ratio, you make remarkable power. We want more pounds of air to flow through our systems, maintain ambient air density all the way to the turbocharger or all the way to the throttle if it's spark ignition. Now he's showing this battery tray. It's a 45-pound battery. It's like putting the battery at the end of a diving board. It's out there, and it's 45 pounds, and it's bolted to the sheet metal fender well. I don't know how long that lasts. If you drive on rough roads, the G-forces as you're bouncing, suddenly you have a 200-pound battery on the end of a diving board tied to sheet metal. Not real durable. So we elected to leave the battery where God put it and design ducting to put the air filter back where it should be. And we out flowed them. But remember, our flow measurement is pounds of air, not cubic feet of air. If you're just measuring cubic feet, you're not measuring the temperature of the air. When you heat air, a cubic foot of air has less mass, less weight, less pounds. So I don't care how big the air filter is. If you put it under the hood, you're inducting hot ass air. A Banks ram air is seeking the coolest ambient air it can get. And you can't get ram air with a filter under the hood. Vehicle velocity is what rams the air that's cold into the intake, into the housing around the filter, keeping it as cold as possible all the way through the filter and to the engine. This is nuts. While this outflows, it probably makes less horsepower because you're getting less air density per cubic foot, less weight per cubic foot, in inducting that hot underhood air, period.
Over 50%. Check the website for the exact data, but It improves it over 50% while giving you radically high efficiency rates with which either filter you end up choosing.
We care about the mass flow, Barry.
So now you got a short shot, air ramming right into the air filter itself.
Within a year, he'll be talking mass flow, I'm telling you.
This takes about an hour to install. The other kit's less than 30 minutes.
Or maybe not. It's a short shot of hot air.
Enclosed air intake kits, but we also believe that the customer's right as well. And so we want to take care of the customer. And there is demand out there for an open style intake. So we want to take care of those customers that want an open.
What if the customer wants fentanyl? You're going to sell them fentanyl? Customer's right, right?
But thanks for your support. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us at sbfilters.com.
Oh, man. Well, actually, I'm glad that's over. I've had enough, guys. Facts are, this is bullshit. I know you guys are going to ask in the comments, Gale, are you going to test this thing? Well, I am. Guys, like and subscribe if you want to see more fact checks just like this. Well, maybe not like this. I don't think I could stomach another one.